morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the VRL Logistics Q1 FY22 results conference call hosted by ICICI Securities Limited. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star then zero on your touchtone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Vijit Mitra from ICICI Securities Limited. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Yeah. Thanks, operator, and good morning to all the participants. Thanks for joining in. We are hosting Q1 FY22 results conference call of VRL Logistics. We have with us Mr. Sunil Nalavadi, CFO of VRL Logistics, to discuss the results and follow on Q&A. Without further ado, over to you, Mr. Nalavadi, for your opening remarks.
Thank you, Mr. Vijit. Good morning to all the participants. I am Sunil Nalavadi, CFO of VRL Logistics Limited, and this is earnings call of our company for the quarter one of financial year 2021-22. Again, the frequent lockdowns in various states in quarter one of FY22 slowed down the momentum that was witnessed in quarter three, quarter four of FY20-21 and beginning of April 2021 as the second COVID surge in India hit alarming levels. In spite of the difficulties faced, the impact on business was lesser than the first wave witnessed last year, as supply chains were well evolved enough to cope with localized and staggered lockdowns. As COVID positivity rate subsequently dropped to pre-COVID second wave levels, overall demand has been trending better since last week of June 2021. During this quarter, the total revenue of the company reached to rupees 417 crores as against 162 crores during the last year. The increase in revenue is mainly contributed by the goods transport segment of our company. The revenue from goods transport segment is increased from rupees 148 crores to rupees 385 crores. The growth in revenue of goods transport segment is on account of increase in realization per ton by 14% and balance is on account of increase in tonnage. The revenue from bus operation is also increased from rupees 5 crores to rupees 18 crores in spite of reduction in number of buses by 46 numbers. The increase in revenue is mainly on account of increase in number of passengers. The total EBITDA of the company is increased by 225% from -32 crores to +40 crores, and the percentage of total income is also increased from -19% to +9.48%. The increase in EBITDA mainly contributed by our goods transport segment, which is increased from -25 crores to +43 crores, and percentage to revenue is increased from -16.67% to +11.19%. The improvement in EBITDA is mainly on account of increase in goods transport volumes and increases in freight rate periodically. We continuously monitoring the diesel rate since the diesel cost is major expenses for our business and accordingly passing the increase in rates by increasing in the freight rates. The retail diesel price is increased from 66 rupees per liter to 95 rupees per liter, whereas our procurement cost is increased from 61 rupees to 84 rupees. The EBITDA of bus segment also improved from -5.72 crores to -3.83 crores. The total EBIT of the company is increased from -73 crores to +2 crores. The increase in EBIT is mainly contributed by our GT segment, which is increased from -56 crores to 14 crores, and bus segment EBIT is improved from -11 crores to -7 crores. On account of improvement in EBITDA and EBIT, the overall PBT of the company is improved from -84 crores to -7 crores, and on account of this, the profit for the quarter is improved from -63 crores to -6 crores. When we compare our performance in this quarter to the previous quarter, the performance is impacted on account of COVID restrictions. During this quarter, the total revenue of the company reached to rupees 417 crores as against 603 crores during the last quarter. The decrease in revenue is mainly contributed by the goods transport segment of the company. The revenue from GT segment is decreased from 536 crores to 385 crores, and decline in revenue of GT segment is on account of decrease in tonnage by 26% and decrease in realization by 2%. The decrease in realization is only due to change in the route mix on account of extended restrictions in multiple states impacted on long-haul freight revenues. The revenue from bus operations is also decreased from 56 crores to 18 crores, and the number of buses were constant at 291 buses. The decrease in revenue is mainly on account of decrease in number of passengers. The total EBITDA of the company is decreased from 99 crores to 40 crores, and the percentage to total income is also decreased from 16% to 9.48%. The decrease in EBITDA mainly contributed by our goods transport segment is decreased from 104 crores to 43 crores, and for percentage to revenue is decreased from 19% to 11%. The decrease in EBITDA is mainly on account of decrease in goods transport volumes that has been resulted into unable to recover the key fixed cost of this segment, mainly the employee cost. As a percentage to the revenue, it is increased from 14% to 19.3%. That is increased by almost 5%. Rent expenses is increased by 1.5%, rates and taxes by 0.6%, and others by 1%. Even though the diesel cost as a percentage to revenue is increased by 1.4%, the same is compensated by decrease in lorry hire charges by 1.45%. The retail diesel price is increased from ₹86 per liter to ₹95 per liter, whereas our procurement cost is increased from ₹79 to ₹84. The EBITDA of bus segment is almost maintained at 3.8 crores. The total EBIT of the company is decreased from 60 crores to rupees 2 crores, and decrease in EBIT is mainly contributed by our goods transport segment, which is decreased from 76 crores to 14 crores, and bus segment EBIT is improved from minus 8.67 crores to minus 7 crores. On account of the decline in EBITDA and EBIT, the overall PBT of the company is decreased from 51 crores to minus 7 crores. And on account of this, profit for the quarter is decreased from 37 crores to minus 6 crores. As at 30th June 2021, the net debt of the company is increased to 112 crores as compared to debt as at 31st March, it was around 101 crores. During the quarter, the company has invested rupees 38 crores in the capital expenditure. I would like to further inform you that the volumes are again picked up at the pre-COVID levels in July, and we also increased the freight rates by 10% in last week of June. We are hoping that again we will bounce back with good growth with higher profitability margin in rest of the period of this financial year. With this initial remark, now I request to the participant to ask any questions.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin with the question and answer session. Anyone wishing to ask a question may please press star and one on your touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. The first question is on the line of Rishit Shah from Dhanki Securities Private Limited. Please go ahead.
Hello. Hello, good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning.
Yeah. This is the question regarding the bus segment. So within the bus segment, can you just highlight quarter on quarter passenger and as well as the realization increase or decrease?
Okay. There are decrease in passenger travel by around 68% and increase in realization by around 19% and decrease in average seat occupation by 9% and decrease in number of trips by 70%. This is quarter on quarter.
70% decrease in number of trips, you said?
Yeah.
Okay, so I mean this was largely on account of the regional lockdowns, is it?
Yes, it is.
Okay, and in the bus segment itself, so can you, I mean, just give us an outlook or how is it, I mean, in July, how is it performing and how do you expect it to continue going forward?
Yeah, in bus segment, what happened? See, even though the goods transport segment is allowed to operate during the restrictions, the bus segment was totally halted. And Karnataka is a major place for contribution in bus segment. So in Karnataka, the lockdown is extended for a major period. That's why the buses have not been operated in first quarter. But however, from last week of June, again the operations have started normally.
Okay, sir. So, and second thing, what was the tonnage number for this particular quarter?
No, we are not sharing any tonnage number. Just we are only sharing the moments in tonnage.
Okay, got it.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Vikram Suryavanshi from PhillipCapital. Please go ahead.
Sir, you shared the details about bus, but if you can just highlight what was average realization in bus, just to get sense of pricing environment in challenging times.
The average realization per passenger, I told, increased by 19%, which is increased from 921 rupees to 1,102 rupees.
Okay. 1,102.
From 921.
Okay, got it. And in case of biodiesel, is it because of availability of fuel or is it because of pricing that it has now moderated to below target level?
Yeah, it is. Both the reasons are there. One is availability. That is a major reason. Even some of the producers, actually they are producing a very small quantity. The reason is their raw material cost has been increased, and that's why our quantity of procurement is also lower in this quarter. But we are more focusing on the buying from the refineries. So accordingly, the difference between refinery and biodiesel in the range of around 2 to 3 rupees.
Okay. And last, basically, we were expecting still there is a scope for improvement in textile contribution. At least some segment within textile are performing now better, particularly in yarn side and all that. Is it now, are we seeing traction even in that sector, or if you can highlight between different sectors how the demand is recovering?
In terms of sector-wise volume, yes, there is a recovery in textile segment. If we see quarter four versus quarter one, there is an improvement of around 3% in textile contribution. And similarly, there is a little bit dip in the agriculture products and equipment. This is because of a seasonality. So since again monsoons are at a good level at this year, again we are hoping that there will be good season in the coming days for agriculture products. But there is a good recovery in textile. Even pharma has shown some 3 to 4% growth, and even industrial goods has been shown some 3% growth. But overall, there are no major mix change in the product, except in these key commodities. So overall, there is a decline in volumes from Q4 to Q1. That's how the volumes also declined.
And last question is on CAPEX. Is there any change in CAPEX plan, or what kind of CAPEX for full year or next year we are planning? And within that, the mix of EV, what we are now trying to add in our fleet. So if you can just give if there any revision or kind of CAPEX what we are.
In first quarter, the CAPEX is incurred around 38 crores, and the goods transport segment we have invested around 32 crores, and we invested around 2 crores for passenger segment also. Some of the vehicles we are buying in passenger only to maintain some of the key routes, around 18 to 20 vehicles we are buying. Again, for the remaining period, yes, again, major CAPEX will be for our goods transport segment only. I think on a full year basis, it will be in the range of around 60 to 70 crores as of today. That's what the plan is.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you. The next question is on the line of Mohit Rathi from CCIPL. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi, sir. Thank you for the opportunity. I have one question regarding this app space. Nowadays, there are apps for goods transport as well. both intra-city and intercity, do we see any kind of competition, or are we also working on building an aggregator? Can you comment something on this?
Sorry, your question is not so clear. Could you repeat the same?
Sure, sir. So nowadays we are seeing these apps for goods transport in intra-city and intercity, both the spaces.
Yeah.
So are we like facing any kind of competition from this space, and are we also working on some kind of aggregator or app? Could you comment on that?
No, the aggregator app is basically to provide information about the availability of the vehicles. So these aggregators will not book the consignment from the customers. Say for example, this is going to be useful even for us also. Wherever we are hiring the vehicles, we are using these apps to get the vehicles from the owners.
Okay, sir, but like, are we
so
also?
These are not directly competitors to us. These are the facilities provided to know the availability of the vehicle in particular area, either for intercity movement or intercity movement.
Sure, but like, if I may add on to that, does it affect our margin in any way? Because, for example, in food aggregator apps, they will take some margin from the restaurants. So does it affect us in any way?
So since the majority of our operation is through own vehicles, the dependency on a hired vehicle is very low in our case. So that will not impact major, it will not impact much on us.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. The next question is in the line of Prateek Kumar from Antique Stock Broking. Please go ahead.
Hello. Yeah, morning, sir. My question is on realization in good segment. So you said that we have increased by June by 10% from June, July onwards. How is it placed on a year-on-year basis for 2Q?
The year-on-year, it is increased by around 14% for a June quarter.
No, I mean post this 10% increase.
No. This is not a forecast. This is, see, the rate is increased in the last week of June.
Yeah.
So the major realization will improve in the from the month of July onwards. So the 10% is not at all, you know, included in this 14% improvement.
Yeah, that's what I was asking. For the September quarter, what would be, like, let's say we don't increase price further, what would be the implied increase for Q2 on an year-on-year basis?
Year-on-year basis, see, July we compared, it is in the range of around 8% increment in realization. 8% on month-on-month basis. So if it is year-on-year basis, it will be in the range of around 20%.
So assuming we have, hypothetically, we have like a 5% cargo growth, we can have a 25% revenue growth in 2Q?
Yeah, absolutely.
Sure. And still flow to like a normalized margins which we saw like in 3Q, 4Q last year?
Yeah, definitely the margins will improve because we have taken a price hike, and even volumes are also at a pre-COVID level. So definitely we are hoping that we will maintain the growth as well as profitability margins.
Okay. And sir, in terms of pricing acceptability, so like 80% of our customers are SME customers. So how do the competition behave in such times in terms of, is everyone increasing pricing or only we are increasing pricing, and how is the customer accepting the pricing? Maybe.
No, everyone is increasing. Basically, we are a little bit delayed in increasing the rate. But most of the people have increased the rate in April, May also. But we have taken an increase in rate in the month of June.
So it's very widely accepted in that sense.
Yeah.
Sure, sir. I'll get back to you.
Thank you. The next question is in the line of Mukesh Sarda from Spark Capital. Please go ahead.
Sir, good morning, and thank you for the opportunity. My first question is on the pricing again. So we have taken this price hike around end of June. So as of now, has this been in effect for all your customers, or will it take some time for it to kind of flow into all your customers, even the larger ones, as the contracts get renewed?
The large contracts, basically, we are having a price escalation clause in relation to the diesel cost. See, all
right.
Contracts are periodically changing the rate depending on the increase in the diesel price. So there is no need to increase rates over there. But for remaining customers, for to whom we don't have a contract, we have increased
okay.
the rate 10%. So on effective basis, the realization is improved from month-on-month basis. Compared to June versus July, it is improved by around 8%. Since year-on-year, it is already increased by 14% in the first quarter. This 8%
okay.
realization will be in addition to that percentage.
Got it. So effectively, we are seeing an 8% increase after your hiked the prices.
Yeah.
Okay. And secondly, sir, just starting the comments that you mentioned that the average diesel price for you in the quarter was 85. Is that what I heard, right, sir?
85 rupees, yes.
Okay, versus the prices, retail prices around 93, 95
rupees,
something like
that. Yeah.
Okay, so this is a big gap. Do you see that, you know, the it kind of hit us more this quarter because probably... We saw,
so the comparison is like this. The closing price of a retail price we are taking, say, for example, as of 31st March or as of 30th.
Yeah, yeah.
But in
right.
case of procurement cost, it is a average price in relation to quantity what we
Got
consume
it.
For the entire quarter.
Right. So this 95 will hit us now, so this quarter. That's what I was trying to ask.
95 is again a retail price.
Yeah.
But our closing price will be in the range of around 85 rupees.
Closing price is 85, sir. June closing price, but was average price was 85, I thought.
Yeah, average is 85 and closing price will be additional 2 to 3 rupees, say in the range of around 87-88 rupees, not beyond that.
Okay. So there's still that 7-8 rupee gap between the retail price and your price.
Yes.
Right. So you'll not need additional price hikes. That's basically what I was asking. So despite this 10% hike that we've taken, you know, even if your procurement price now goes up based on the closing price of June, it's not like you'll need additional price hikes.
No, as of now, in our view, this 10% increase will take care of this existing diesel price now.
Okay.
Whatever the retail price as of today or whatever market price. If going forward again it increases beyond certain level, again we have to take a call on increase in the rates. Even in last financial year, if we increase the rate by 10% in the month of April, that has
right.
been taken care by the entire year. That's how it has been resulted in good improvement in the margin on quarter two onwards.
Right.
So similarly, since this 10% will take care of you know, the whatever diesel escalation in the coming days.
Okay. Understood. And just my last thing is
Once volume start increasing, again the capacity will improve, utilization levels will improve, and moreover, burden on for fixed expenses will come down on the margins.
So I was just trying to assess the gross margin side of it. So yeah, I get it on the operating leverage side. Yes, that definitely will play. Right. And my last thing is on the hired vehicles in this April to June quarter, what proportion did we see, sir, hired vehicles?
It is reduced by 1.45%, and on an overall basis, the hired vehicle reduced from, say, around 9 to 7%.
Okay, 9 to 7. And this, I mean, as you said, like, you know, as the volumes go up, even this will go up, right? The hired vehicles. It used to be even 14-15% at some point in time. So how much do you see this go up, sir?
Not increase beyond 9-10%.
Okay, it will stay around that 9-10%.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, sir. Right. I'll get back in the queue. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Achal from JM Financial.
Go ahead. Yeah, good morning. Thank you for the opportunity. So my question is, if you could give us a sense in terms of the volume growth once again, please, for the GT segment on a YOY and QOQ basis, how has was in first quarter?
The volume in first quarter, there is an improvement in revenue from say 148 to 385 crores. Out of that, the 14% increase in revenue on account of increase in tonnage, and balance is on account of increase in the volumes. If it is comes
and,
to
QOQ
on a QOQ basis, the volumes have decreased by 26%, and the realization is also decreased by around 2%.
Right, and if we were to look at June 2019 quarter, how would that number be in terms of volume, absolute volume drop? Just the volume part, sir.
No, last year June to this June, it has improved actually.
The volumes are up compared to June 19 quarter, sir?
Yes, yes.
How much would that be?
It is around 160%. 160-170% increase in volume.
160% compared to June 19. Is that so?
Yeah.
Okay. My second question, in terms of the margin, so how do we look at the margins internally? You know, is it we look at a particular margin on a rupees per kilometer, per ton kilometer, or is it percentage we work with?
Basically it again we do the route wise analysis and state wise analysis, basically the movement of goods from one state to another state, and accordingly we go on fixing the rate, and we study the competitive analysis also in a particular route. So depending on that we fix our rates. So again, in margin side, what we do is every month we keep on, you know, getting the MIS report, and we study all major expenses. It may be fuel and it may be other costs also, like employee cost, maintenance cost, everything. So based on that, if fuel prices is increasing directly, we can increase the rates. And wherever possible, say fixed expenses, we will try to reduce the fixed expenses so that margin will improve.
Right.
But increase in freight rates, basically, in a periodic basis, whenever we do during the middle of financial year, it is directly driven by the fuel price. And once in a year, based on other expenses also, we will take care, we will decide on the increase in rate based on other expenses other than fuel as well.
Right. But when you look at the hiking the rate, let's say for fuel, do you look at the margin stability more from percentage perspective, or the rupees per ton kilometer kind of a number? I'm just trying to figure out, you know, in terms of diesel, when it went up from 60 to 90, does that mean the percentage margin will be lower, even the absolute profit could be much higher? Would that be fair assumption?
So in June quarter, say for example, percentage to revenue, it is increased by say 30% to 32%. So 2% we have to pass it on to the customer. So that's why since it is the first increase in the financial year, we have increased by around 10%.
Which takes care of the other expenses also, which are going up.
Takes care of other expenses, and last price hike we did in last April 2020. From April 2020, we have not increased the rate. Again, we have increased the rate only in June 21. So with the combination of all analysis of all expenses as well as the fuel expenses, we increase the rates by 10%.
Understood. Another question I had, with respect to the competitors. So, have you seen in last, say, 12, 18 months, competitive intensity somewhat waning or reducing, or it remains as competitive as it was earlier as well? Like, I have some of the unorganized kind of shut down, folded up, or anything like that.
Yeah. The position of some of the competitors in unorganized sector is not so highly intensive because their financial position is not up to the mark as of today. That's why, you know, even we are gaining some of the good market share. And accordingly, from June onwards to July, immediately the entire volumes have been recovered. We are expecting good growth in the coming days. So it, another reason for this is because of low intensity from the competitors in the unorganized market.
And is it any particular region, any particular segment, or it's across the board?
No, it is across the market.
Understood. And just last question, sir, with respect to CapEx, you did talk about 60-70 crores. But if we were to look at more from medium term perspective, do you see, you know, a substantial increase in the CapEx given the way, you know, the volumes are improving, competition is kind of reducing? Are we looking at a significant change, over the regular CapEx?
Basically, in our case, the CapEx plan we do at a very short term plan, because depending on the movement in the volumes, we have to plan for the CapEx. Say, for example, if things are improved like this going forward, if the volumes are increased by, say, 20-25%, then definitely we need to add more number of vehicles. At that time, again, we can invest on the capital expenditure. But till that time, we are having a scope that we can engage outside vehicle the moment volumes are increased. So immediately there is no need to increase our own vehicles. So if that volume continuously increase, and if it is a permanent increase in the volume, then we will go for our own vehicles.
Understood. This is helpful, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Chetan Shah from Jeet Capital. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi. Good morning, sir. Just one question in terms of the business mix, specifically in the goods side. Can you just give us some flavor about the regional improvement? You mentioned about the industry and the sector specific, but is there any part of the country which is doing relatively better than the other? And my second question is, sir, the way the infrastructure, mainly the road, is improving, does it increasing our throughput or a turnaround time for our vehicle? How is your experience for a couple of years? If you can give some sense on that, that will be very helpful, please.
Sure. So basically, in terms of geographical mix, yes, in our case, the south region is contributing, say, around 40% of total tonnage what we are handling, and north and west contributing around 20%, and remaining part of the country around 10%. But during this lockdown restrictions, basically the tonnage is impacted from south to north and north to south. On account of that, even realization of per ton of goods transport segment is reduced by 2% in this quarter, even though rates have not been reduced. And when it comes to the turnaround time of the vehicles, yes, kilometer from individual vehicles are increasing. And even in Q3 and Q4, we mentioned very specifically that the kilometers from the own vehicles have been improved. Say the improvement is in the range of, say, around 5-8%. There is an improvement in the kilometer, but still we can improve on these kilometers once the tolls have been abolished. The government is planning to abolish the tolls. So once these are abolished, we are envisaging that another 5-6%, there is a scope to increase in the kilometers. And continuously we are monitoring the movement of the vehicles, and we are putting more effort on the driver efficiency and all these things. So we are having good scope to increase the kilometers.
Sir, one last question from my side. In terms of our fixed overheads, is there any significant improvement in last 2 or 3 quarters? So what we did say last year post COVID, and before that also we were trying to do some efficient improvement, but I'm just trying to understand that is there any scope to tweak any cost over there which can increase our EBITDA margin on a sustainable basis going forward?
See, the key major fixed expenses in our case, again, the one is major employee cost. Employee cost, yes, last year what we did some reshuffling of the employees, we did some recovery, the salary cut process and all these things. But this time, since the operations were on, we have not done that kind of a exercise. Even though overall basis, the quarter on quarter, there is a reduction in employee cost by around 3 to 4 crores. But there is no further scope to reduce this employee cost. And further, another major expenses is the rent to our various godowns and premises. There also, last time we asked for each and every owner to give a waiver or waiver for increase in the rent or give waiver for rent also. So based on that, our request, one time they have given a benefit of in the range of around 6 to 7 crores. And in case of vehicle taxes, again, it is another major fixed expenses for us. Last time we opted for non-use option for the vehicles for a long-term halting. At least say 3 months halting needs to be done for the vehicles once we opt for that non-use. But that kind of circumstances were not there in the current situation in the first quarter. So okay, whatever we are incurring today, there is no major scope to fix these expenses. We have taken almost all steps to have a control on these expenses.
Sir, just sorry, I'm just asking one more extra question, just for my understanding. Sir, out of our total goods and transport business, how much percentage in terms of revenue or tonnage will be a fixed contract long term with our customer, and how much will be on the spot or immediate? If you can just give that number, and how that number have moved in last 2 years.
It is almost constant. We are having a contractual customer in the range of around 18 to 20% of our goods transport business.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is on the line of Vikram Suryavanshi from Philip Capital. Please go ahead.
Sir, can you share what was the lorry hire charges in rupees crore?
Want in rupees?
Yeah.
1 second.
It was 7% in this quarter, right? In terms of percentage.
Yeah, I'll tell you. Yeah, lorry hire charges, it is around 39 crores. In the last quarter.
Okay.
It has been and reduced from quarter on quarter basis, it has been reduced from 39 crores to 25 crores.
So it has been reduced
from 7.5% to say around 6.6%.
Okay. So the absolute number was 25 crore this quarter.
39 crores to 25 crores in the quarter.
Perfect, got it. And what I heard is that diesel cost as a percentage was around 32%. Was that right?
Yes, 32%. It is increased from 32%.
32% is on QOQ or YOY?
Quarter on quarter.
QOQ, okay. Understood. And just is how we see the cash flow improvement or working capital. So if you can just highlight what was operating cash flow this quarter or how is the total cash balance?
Yeah, cash flows are not improved much in this quarter because, again, we have incurred a capex also. If we see cash flow from operations, at the EBITDA level, again, it is a decrease from quarter on quarter. Accordingly, it impacted on the cash flows also.
Understood. Okay. And last one about scrapping policy. Is there any further development or how you are looking at the outlook post scrapping policy and impact on the market?
The scrappage policy, again, it is effective from 1st April 2023. So till that date, our plan is wherever we are supposed to incur major expenses for our vehicles, so such vehicles we are scrapping. Say, for example, a vehicle which is already crossed say 20 plus years or 15 plus years, if we need to do any major expenses for maintenance, we are not doing those maintenance and we are scrapping those vehicles. That strategy will continue until April 2023.
Okay, got it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. A reminder to the participants, anyone wishing to ask a question, may please press star and one. The next question is on the line of Dipesh from Equitas Securities. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi Sunil sir, thanks for taking my questions. Sir, in the passenger segment, we used to have nearly 400 plus buses, which have come down to around 291 buses now. So now that your buses have gotten All India permit and the outlook is also looking good, so do you plan to scale this segment back to your original levels?
Yeah, as of today, see, to maintain some good of the good routes, we are adding around 20 vehicles in the current year. And basically, since the life of these vehicles have been increased on account of All India permit for the vehicles, even for the buses, so definitely we will maintain at this level until the things are improved. But once the passenger levels are improved, once occupancy levels are improved, then definitely we will have a more scope to increase the rates also, rate per passenger. But as of today, the strategy is to maintain at this level and to operate at a very premium route. So once the things are normalized and there is no further, you know, anticipation of these lockdowns and all, again, we can think on investment in this segment.
Got
but
it.
Till that and time, we will maintain at the same level.
Sure. So the 20 vehicles that you plan to add in this current year, that you've already done, right, in Q1, right?
Yeah, we bought a chassis. It is in the work in progress. And the major investment has been done in Q1. Yeah, almost around 2.5 crores we have already invested in Q1. Only some body expenses we have to invest further in this quarter. It will not be major expenses.
Got it. And so also your total capex in Q1 was around 38 crore that you told. So that mainly looks towards the smaller vehicle addition, right? But your total capacity has actually decreased in first quarter versus the last quarter. So just wanted to understand what kind of volume growth are you building in and what kind of capacity addition that you did need to cater to that volume growth?
Now, basically, see, again, the volume growth we are anticipating in the normal course of business. Say in quarter 3, quarter 4 onwards, we are expecting around 15% growth in the volumes. So irrespective of this decline, major up and downs, in a normal course of business, say, for example, quarter 3, what we did in last year, quarter 4, what we did in last year, over and above 15%, we are expecting volume growth in quarter 3 and quarter 4 of this year.
Okay, so
and,
the
capex to that improvement again, see, it depends on a vehicle turnaround time and all these things. So, depending on that, actually, we will plan for a capex. But as of today, the total capex plans are in the range of around 50 to 60 crore.
Okay, but just to confirm, sir, the second half was very good for you last year. So, you were expecting 15% growth on that in volume terms, your system.
Yeah. Over and above 15% growth, we are expecting. Yes.
Plus the around 20% is the pricing growth that you have, right? So
pricing 10% is already increased from June last week.
Right.
So this will continue until the major change in the fuel cost.
Right.
And we are hoping that fuel cost will be maintained at this level. If it will be maintained at this level, there will not be increase in the freight rate.
Got it, sir. And sir, in the Q3, Q4 last year, like we did a GT segment, a EBITDA margin of 19-odd%, given those kind of volumes. So if the volumes improve further, do you think the margins can improve further from these numbers?
Yeah, absolutely. See, from the current level, see, as I explained, in the first quarter, decrease in EBITDA is only on account of fixed expenses, fixed cost.
Right.
If volumes start increasing, obviously, there will not be much burden of these fixed costs on the margins. So, again, we will be back in goods transport segment with a EBITDA margin of around 19-20%.
Great, sir. Great to hear that. Thank you so much and all the best.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is on the line of Krupa Shankar NJ from Spark Capital. Please go ahead.
Good morning, sir, and thank you for the opportunity. I had just one question to ask. You did mention that the route mix has impacted during this quarter, so on the realization. So the 2% decline which you have seen in on a QOQ basis would normalize from the second quarter onwards. And in addition to the price hikes which you have taken, which will effectively be about 8%. So are you saying that the realization should be anywhere between about 10-12% on a QOQ increase in the second quarter? Is my understanding correct?
Yeah, July is compared to June month-on-month, it is improved by around 8%. There is a scope for further improvement in August and September.
Right, and the route mix coming back to normalcy would also aid realization.
July, it is almost normal. With that normalcy, there is an improvement of 8% in realization.
Okay, understood.
Yeah.
Okay. And if I may, one more question. Sir, on your overall growth, what you stated on a 15% YOY in the second half, and as I remember, in the fourth quarter, you had mentioned that you were running at optimal utilization or rather peak utilization of your existing assets. And given the capex of incremental trucks which will be added will be relatively lower. So is it fair to assume that the higher charges would go up higher than 9-10% in the second half if your tonnage is going to go up by about 15%?
Yes. If we will not add a vehicle, then we have to hire the vehicles to move those additional tonnage. Then accordingly, the higher charges will increase.
So these are all
variable costs. It will not put any pressure on the margin side.
I understand. Okay. Got it, sir. Thank you. Thanks a lot. That's it from my side.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Prateek Kumar from Antique Stock Broking. Please go ahead.
Hello. Yeah, sir. Thanks for the opportunity. Just to recall this price hike.
Sorry to interrupt, Mr. Kumar. Sir, your voice is breaking up.
Yeah, can you hear me now?
A little better. Thank you.
So I was asking that we took this 8-10% hike in June. Just to recall, when was the last price hike? Was it in first quarter last year, or we have taken like multiple hikes during FY21?
In April 20, we did a 10% hike. Afterwards, there are no increase in the freight rates.
This 20% year-on-year increase, which we will possibly see in second quarter 22, will remain at that number for remaining part of the year as well. So third quarter also and fourth quarter also, we will see like a 20% kind of year-on-year price increase, and that number will not sort of abate because there was no incremental hike in base year.
Yes.
And over and above that, we are expecting like a sort of 15%, assuming business normal, 15% volume growth in second half.
Correct.
Sure, sir. That was just clarification I wanted. Thank you.
Thank you. A reminder to the participants, anyone wishing to ask a question, may please press star and one. The next question is on the line of Rishit Shah from Dhanki Securities Private Limited. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Thanks for the opportunity again. So this is regarding just the branches. So earlier you had mentioned that you are looking to convert some of the agency branches into your own branches. So what is the progress over there, and also what is kind of the outlook in the total number of branches for this year you're looking to add? Thank you.
The conversion from agency to branches will not be major numbers going forward, because whatever agencies we are continuing, these agencies are with the company for a long time, and they are showing good progress also. And when it comes to opening of branches, yes, we are opening up some of the branches, especially in east and northeast part. That area actually we are capturing as of today, because that area contribution to our business is very low as of today. So considering there is a scope for improvement in this area, we are opening some of the new branches, and we may add around 40 to 50 branches in these areas.
Okay, great. Thanks, Rita. Thank you.
Thank you. A reminder to the participants, anyone wishing to ask a question, may please press star and one. Participants, if you wish to ask a question, you may please press star and one. The next question is from the line of Shivaji Mehta, an investor. Please go ahead.
Hi, thanks for this opportunity. So this 15% volume growth guidance that you've given, if you could just give some color regarding, you know, any end user industry where you're seeing such, you know, this kind of attraction, or is it more broad-based?
No, it is a broad-based. See, one is geographical improvement, the growth will be there. Since we are adding some of the branches in untapped market, that will, you know, give another boost to increase in the tonnage. And apart from that, on account of improvement in the economy and other things, again, now the overall growth, it will come. And so moreover, we are doing a highly focused marketing as of today. In a particular areas, we are focusing on the inward, outward materials and the movement of the goods from each particular area, each particular market. So it is a highly focused marketing what we are doing as of today. So considering all these things, it is a broad indication that there will be improvement in the tonnage at that level.
Sure, makes sense. So one last question from my side. You know, I think in the last few years, we've done a lot of efforts in terms of closing down, you know, unprofitable branches, adding newer branches. So just trying to understand from a slightly more long-term perspective, say, you know, 3, 4, 5 years, what is the volume growth that, you know, after all these efforts that we have put in, that we can target? And now we are now, as you also guided, you know, you're expecting a 15% volume growth. So things are moving. So just from a slightly more long-term perspective, what would be that volume growth for you?
Yeah, standstill on a long-term basis, again, see, there is a lot of shift from unorganized to organized market because of the GST and e-way bill compliances that, you know, burden is hitting very hard to the small-scale operators or even unorganized players. So with that, we are hoping that there will be good scope to add new customers in the coming days. And definitely on an overall basis, even after this financial year, there will be a chance to improve the tonnage by around 10 to 15%.
Thanks a lot, sir, and all the best.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. A reminder to the participants, anyone wishing to ask a question, may please press star and one. Participants, if you wish to ask a question, you may please press star and one.
You can conclude a call, madam, if there are no further questions.
Thank you, sir. Would you like to add any closing remarks?
Yeah, nothing. We covered almost all areas. Thanks to all the participants for their patience hearing. Thank you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of ICICI Securities, that concludes this conference call. We thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.